Hello? What do I want? I want Cadbury's.
The Cadbury Show!
Ah, yes, and by that you mean Cadbury's Dairy Milk Chocolate, Elsie. Only smooth, creamy dairy milk has a glass and a half of pure, fresh, full cream milk in each half pound. That explains why each thick, chunky square is so nourishing. Only dairy milk has Cadbury top quality chocolate, too. Perfectly blended chocolate made even more delicious with milk. Milk, fresh, creamy milk. Enjoy a block of Cadbury's Dairy Milk whenever you want a satisfying, deep-flavored chocolate. You can always be sure of unvarying quality in Cadbury's Dairy Milk. Look for Dairy Milk chocolate everywhere in the shining purple and gold wrapper.
Reg, I was wondering, do you think I should make out my will?
Your will? Well, no, don't do it, Elsie.
Why not?
Well, as I've always said, a will is nothing but a dead giveaway.
Is that so? Well, Uncle Hugo wrote one. That's why he had to go to the Court of Reprobate.
No, 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 Elsie. You mean the Court of Probate. You don't know your law.
Yes, I do. It was a Court of Reprobate. You don't know Uncle Hugo.
Oh. Well, look, if you do decide to ride on, I'll hope you'll remember your old pal, Reginald Goldsworthy.
Of course I'll remember you, Reg. You'll get nothing.
Oh, Elsie.
Now, listen seriously, Reg. Of all the things I possess, of all the things I treasure most, what would you choose?
There's one thing that'll always remind me of you, Elsie.
And what's that?
I want what everybody wants, Elsie. I want Cadbury's.
Fruit! Fruit!
Oh, hello, Mr. Hercules. What brings you here?
Me new delivery truck. It's a convertible. I can turn it from a fruit truck to a hearse in 20 seconds.
Oh, and what's the idea of that?
Well, some of me customers are getting on, you know, and I don't want to lose their trade.
Well, I'm glad you're here early because I want you to help me. It's Percy's birthday and I've planned a surprise party for him.
Doesn't he know anything about it?
Percy doesn't know anything about anything. But I've kept it a strict secret and I want you to help me to get rid of him for a couple of hours when the guests arrive in their costumes.
That's no trouble. But what's the idea of making it a costume party?
I like them. I think they're colourful. I'm dressing as Madame Butterfly.
What about Percy? What are you going to do about him wearing a fancy costume?
Oh, I've got a Scottish Highlanders outfit for him. I've even got the sporran and the kilts.
Oh, imagine old knobby knees in kilts.
Never mind, the bagpipes will hide his knees. But I've got a surprise for you too, Mr. Hercules. I've hired a Peter Pan costume for you. What do you say to that?
I say put up your dukes. We're going to have this out right here and now. Me in a Peter Pan costume.
Well, everyone else will be in fancy dress.
Well, I'll wear something of my own. I know. Me old Navy uniform.
I didn't know you were in the Navy.
Oh, yes. As a matter of fact, that's where I met Percy. We were old brig mates.
You were on a brig?
Not on it. In it. Say, how are you going to get Percy into the kilts without arising his suspicion?
Oh, I'll think of something.
Wouldn't it be easier to get him into his old naval uniform?
Yes, but we'll only try that as a last resort. After all, I've hired the kilts.
Good night, gentlemen. Hello, Mr. Herc. How's the green grocery business?
In the pink. In the pink.
That's funny. I thought you were in the greens. I'm sharp today. What have you got in your basket?
A slice of mouldy bread.
What's that for?
I'm making me own penicillin, you know. As a matter of fact, I'm on a new invention.
Ah, what is it?
Well, it's 12 times better than penicillin. It's called chillin'cillin. You're not the only one that's sharp.
Yeah, but with you, I don't get the point.
Percy, your kilts are back from the cleaners.
Thanks, Tillybone. Now, about this What?
I said your kilts have come back from the dry cleaners.
Well, it's about time to... Hey, what's wrong here? Were you kicked by a horse or something?
No, Percy, I'm all right.
Now, Mr. Herc, give us a hand, will you? We'll walk around the block a couple of times.
There's nothing wrong with her, Percy.
Then why is she trying to get me to wear kilts?
Well, perhaps she's got scotch broth for tea.
Must have been the sun. It was pretty warm today.
Well, what about putting on your sailor suit?
Now, I know she's potty. Come on, Jellybean. The psychiatrist will be here in a minute.
There's no need to get up, sirs. Purse, she's quite all right.
Well, I never thought I'd see the day when I'd be the only sober one in the house. Why should I wear me old sailor suit?
Well, I'm going to wear mine.
That does it. I'll sign the pledge.
But we have to wear our sailor suits.
Why?
Why? Because...
Mr. Hercules?
Oh, yes. Because tonight is the reunion of our old shipmates.
Well, why didn't you say so before?
I only just thought of it. I mean, I just remembered it. We have to be at the sailor's barracks at 6:30.
We do? Well, I better go and start getting into my uniform.
Why now? There's another 2 hours to go.
I know, but it'll take me that long to do up all the buttons.
Well, Purse, I've got me sailor suit on. What's taking you so long?
I'm still buttoning. No wonder they make you sign on for 5 years at a time. Takes that long to get into your trousers. Oh, gee, Herc, it feels good to be back in the old uniform.
I'll say. Hey, Purse, you look pretty good.
Do you think so?
Yeah. You're the only person that is the right figure to wear bell-bottom trousers.
Oi, oi.
But doesn't the old uniform bring back memories?
Too right. Remember that night in Honolulu?
Oh, yes. That was the night.
You remember the time we got the weekend leave and went to Waikiki? First we went to that wild party in the wardroom. Then we went on to a cabaret. Then you got that bright idea and we gape-crashed the officer's mess. Then we went moonlight swimming and we spent the whole of the next day on the beach. Do you remember that weekend?
Only up to the wild party in the wardroom. But that's remarkable. How do you remember the rest of the leave?
They told me all about it at the court-martial.
Anyway, I've got to admit it, you really look smart in your uniform, Purse.
I wonder what Jellybean thinks. Ah, hoy there, me shipmates. Look about.
Oh, goodness. You do look good, Purse, and you too, Mr. Hercules.
You're not so bad yourself, baby. How about a date?
Oh, oi, oi, fair go, sport. She'll cancel our leave.
Now tell me, what time are you due to join the mothball fleet?
Landlubber. Let's fire a shot across her bows.
Not me, she's too strong in the stern.
Well, shipmate, you may pipe me ashore.
Aye, aye, sir.
Oh, well, life on the ocean wave, a life on the bounding main.
Now, don't you forget, you two, I want you both back here at 8:00.
Which day?
Don't worry, I'll have him back.
Well, 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 and where are the Sea Scouts off today?
Listen, Minnie, do you know why we're wearing these sailor suits?
Because your Girl Guide uniforms are at the laundry.
These aren't play suits, you know. These are regulation Navy uniform. This uniform was in a real battle.
Judging by the look of it, must have been in the rear guard action.
Ah, come on, Herc. We haven't got time to argue with this old dreadnought. We've got to get to our reunion.
Reunion? Then you really are wearing naval uniform?
Of course we are, men. Now what do you say?
Well, all I can say is thank goodness we've still got the Army and Air Force.
Now we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along singing a song side by side. Don't know what's coming tomorrow. Maybe it's trouble and sorrow, but we'll travel the road sharing our load side by side. Through all kinds of weather, what if the sky should fall? As long as we're together, it does not matter at all. When they've all had their quarrels and parted, we'll be the same as we started, just traveling along, singing a song, side by side. Now we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song, side by side.
bite deep into a block of Cadbury's Candy Nut Chocolate, and you'll say there's something different about this chocolate. You'll be right, too, because Candy Nut is deliciously different. It's not simply a creamy milk chocolate. It's the perfect blend of famous dairy milk chocolate and candied peanuts. Here's a combination that'll really tease your palate. A double flavor treat in one chocolate block. First off, you'll recognize smooth, creamy dairy milk chocolate. Then peanuts, roasted to full flavor and thickly coated with crisp, crunchy candy. Yes, Candy Nut is different, all right. You'll love to try it often. Ask for Cadbury's Candy Nut Chocolate tomorrow. Candy Nut is full of the flavor that'll have you saying, I want Cadbury's.
Hello, Mum. Remember me? I'm Sam Poole, the salesman.
Oh, hello, Sam. Look, you caught me at a rather bad time. I'm having a party tonight and I'm very busy.
A party, eh? Well, maybe I just got the very thing for you in my suitcase here. Here. How about this stainless onion peeler?
Yes, but where would I get any stainless onions?
Well, what about this here patent plastic patcher? It patches all sorts of clothing, even darned old dirndls.
No, thanks, Sam. We never patch our clothes.
Oh, no. Now, of course, I was forgetting. They've already patched them when you get them from the mission. Now, look, what would you say if I showed you a fur coat?
Mama always told me to say no.
Oh, no, Mum. Look, I just wondered if you wanted to buy one. I got a nice line of, as they say in French, Terrier Écossais.
And what's that in English?
Scotch Terrier.
No, Sam, no thank you.
Hey, Mum, what's all this about having a party? What's the chance of me getting an invite, eh?
Oh, I don't know, Sam. I don't like asking the tradesmen.
There you are. It's the same the old world over. That's what everybody says. I'm just a piece of flotsam adrift on the social sea. Maybe I ought to submerge and drown myself.
All right. You win. I'll invite you.
Hey, gee, Mum, that's decent of you. Hey, you're big, you know that? Nothing personal, I'm sure.
Well, it's going to be a costume party. Have you got a fancy dress?
No. Only me prison pajamas. Somehow I don't feel as though I'm dressed up in them. Maybe I'm too used to them. What do you think?
Well, I've got a Peter Pan costume you can have.
Gee, Peter Pan, eh? That's decent of you, Mum.
I remember when I was a little girl, I played the part of Peter Pan in a Christmas panto.
Blimey. Did they have Peter Pan that long ago? Oh, I'm sorry, Mum. What I meant to say was, did they have Christmas that long ago?
Sir.
Oh, only asking. Sorry. Hey, what's your boyfriend wearing?
He'd look good as a gasometer.
My purse is wearing his full naval uniform. And as a matter of fact, here, Mr. Hercules, are due back in half an hour. Oh, I do hope Mr. Hercules doesn't mess up arrangements. He's not the most reliable of people at the best of times.
Look, Herc, when does the fun start? We've been waiting 2 hours and none of the blokes have turned up.
I wonder what happened.
I can't imagine. Are you sure you got the right night?
That depends. What time is it?
7:50.
Wrong night. Let's get back to Miss Elsie's house.
You know, it's the funniest thing. They were always so reliable.
Oh, don't worry. I must have made a mistake. Let's go home.
Maybe you made a mistake about the meeting place. Maybe the boys are waiting somewhere else. There's a lot of halls around the town. Let's ask somebody.
Look, Purse, if they're not down here at the Navy Barracks, they won't be anywhere.
Look, here's a bloke in uniform. Let's ask him.
No, Purse, not him. He's a commander.
Well, he might know something anyway. Hey, mate, come here.
Are you addressing me, you sailor?
Well, there's nobody with you. Look, sport, I just want to ask you a question.
When you're talking to a superior officer, stand to attention and salute.
Look here, Mug, I haven't got time to waste playing games.
Do you realize who you're talking to? I'm a commander.
Well, good luck to you. Isn't that nice? Did you hear that, Herc? He's a commander.
Oh, that's very nice. I'm always glad to see a clean-cut young fella like this get ahead.
Me too. You must polish the right brass, eh, sport?
Silence! One step forward. I want a good look at you so that I can... Oh, good heavens, I must speak to the recruiting office. They're sending us wrinkled ones now.
That's a nasty remark. I don't have to stand here and be insulted by the likes of you. Just because you've got all that gold braid all over you doesn't mean you...
Silence! What ship are you from?
The good ship Lollipop. Might as well hear me, mate.
How did you two ever get into the Navy? You're a disgrace to those uniforms.
What uniform? Oh. Oh, these sailor suits. Oh, I forgot we were wearing them. I'm sorry, it's a misunderstanding. You see, we're not in the Navy.
What? Not in the Navy? You're wearing uniforms? Gad, you'll go up for this. Patrol!
Hey, wait a minute, Commander. Sir, your Admiralship, sire, it's like this, Your Highness. We're not spies. We're just wearing these uniforms because we're going to a reunion of our old shipmates. Aren't we, Irk?
No.
Then why are we wearing them?
I can't tell you. I've been sworn to secrecy.
I knew it! You are spies! Take them away!
Please, Irk, tell them we're not spies. Tell them why we're wearing these uniforms.
I tell you, I can't. I'm sworn to secrecy on account of the party.
The party? That does it! Off to the board with you!
Oh, no!
Words were spoken. Now all I have is memory to cherish so tenderly with every token you have given to me. I love to well, for I darkened you in my heart. My life was hell every moment we were apart. Why did I make that big mistake? I wronged you right from the start. Was all over my jealousy. My crime was my blind jealousy. My heart was a fire with desire for you. But I never thought that your love was true. You gave all your kisses to me. But now, all too late, I can see the heartaches I cost you. Oh, wonder I lost you. Was over my jealousy.
The deep flavor and nourishing goodness, you can always put your trust in Cadbury's Dairy Milk as everything that a good chocolate should be. It contains Cadbury quality chocolate, the smoother, more satisfying chocolate that makes each square thick and chunky. Then there's milk. Milk, fresh, creamy milk, blended to make it full of deep down flavor, full of wholesome goodness. Dairy Milk has always been the same, top value chocolate, as creamy as a creamy chocolate can be. Make it a habit to call in regularly for a block of Cadbury's Dairy Milk. Remember, only Dairy Milk has a glass and a half of pure, fresh, full cream milk in each half pound. That in itself makes Dairy Milk chocolate a world-famous reason for I want Cadbury's.
Look, Commander, you can't keep us in the brig like this. I tell you, we're not spies.
No, yes you are. Carew can tell a spy at one glance. They're dash clever, these Chinese. Who'd think to look at these two fellows? Who'd think that they were agents? They look too stupid.
Oi, oi.
Oh, Carew, you daredevil, you. Single-handed, you caught these villainous rogues. You'll fetch a promotion for this.
Look, Herc, tell him why. Please tell him why. We'll be shot at dawn if you don't.
I can't, Purse. It's a secret.
Look, Commander, we're not spies, I tell you.
No, no. All I know is that you were hanging around the Navy barracks wearing naval uniforms. Why?
I wish I knew myself. Go on, Herc, tell him.
All right. I'll tell him.
Aha, I knew your nerve would crack. Now tell me, why is this man wearing a sailor's uniform?
Because he's too knock-kneed to wear kilts.
Herc, this is no time for bad jokes. Look, I'm no spy. I fought in the last war. That proves I'm loyal.
I don't know. I've looked up your record, and I'm beginning to wonder just whose side you were on.
Ah, you're talking about that accident I had with the ship's gun.
Accident? You call shooting the captain in his seat of learning an accident? And what about the time the captain fell out of the crow's nest? What did you do?
I moved the boat to one side so he wouldn't hit the deck.
Fine seaman you were. Now take myself, for instance. I was the captain of a bark in the Great Australian Bight.
Yeah? They say the bite is pretty bad.
Yes, but my bark was worse than the bite. Well, there I was, faced with one of the biggest problems to come out of the war.
What was that?
I didn't know how to start the engine. Nobody had given me the ignition keys, and I didn't know how to release the handbrake.
What did you do?
Oh, Gad, you mad, ingenious rascal, Carew. I ordered full steam ahead, and we maintained that speed for 3/4 of an hour.
Did you manage to get away all right?
Actually, no. You see, we were still tied up to the wharf. But that doesn't solve your problem, does it?
Look, Commander, I'm Purse Brown of Cuckoo Avenue. I've been out of the Navy for years. Ask Elsie Smith.
Elsie Smith? You mean the Elsie Smith of Cuckoo Avenue?
That's her.
Gad, she was a gay girl with the sailors. I remember my grandfather telling me how he took her on a trip on his wind down.
Well, you ask her, sir, and she'll come down here and identify me. Go on.
All right. If she can identify you, I'll let you go. I'll give her a call on the blower.
Oh, no, don't call Elsie. That'll spoil everything.
Keep quiet. Don't you realize that when Elsie gets down here, she'll get us out?
But I don't want Elsie to come down. It'll give the whole thing away.
Oh, boy. This is one time in your life when you really do need to see a doctor.
Well, this certainly is a colourful party, Miss Elsie.
But, Sam, do you think that Purse will recognise me in this Madame Butterfly costume?
Well, let's have a look. No, not likely, Mum. With that black wig and the yellow makeup, you know, you look just like a Japanese girl.
Do I?
Yeah.
You know, I wonder where Purse and Mr. Hercules are. It's nearly 9 o'clock. Oh, that might be them now. Hello? Yes, this is Elsie Smith. You've got them where? In the brig? Oh, no! I'll be right down. Sam, I want you to drive me down to the naval barracks.
Okay, Miss Elsie. We're in costume. I've got me Peter Pan suit on.
Well, we haven't got time to change. Come on, let's go.
Hey, Commander. When are you going to let us out of this brig?
Just as soon as Elsie Smith gets here to identify you. She's on her way now.
Thank goodness.
Oh, Purse, you shouldn't have let him call her. I only hope that when she comes, she isn't dressed.
What kind of a crack is that?
No, I mean... Oh, well, you'll find out when Elsie gets here.
I can't wait.
Come in. This will be her now.
Oh, Purse, darling, I got here just as soon as I could.
Well, it's about time you... Hey, who's the geisha girl?
Don't you recognise me? It's me, your fiancé.
Herc, did we ever have any leave in Japan?
Not that I remember.
Now look here, lady, I don't know who you are, but you're not my fiancé.
I didn't think she was Elsie Smith. She's not like my grandfather's description, one iota.
Well, I am Elsie Smith. I'm engaged to this man. Now, come on, Purse. Come home with me, and you too, Mr. Hercules.
Get away from me, Tokyo Rose.
I am not Tokyo Rose.
Then why are you wearing that Japanese dress?
I'm Madame Butterfly.
I thought you said you were Elsie Smith.
Well, I usually am, but tonight I'm Madame Butterfly.
Oh! And I suppose tomorrow night you'll be Peter Pan.
Oh, no, no, that's silly. Peter Pan's outside in the car. He drove me down.
Now, let me get this straight. You're Madame Butterfly and Peter Pan drove you down here. Now, tell me,
Where's Napoleon?
Oh, he's at home waiting for us to come back.
Is Josephine with him?
Yes, and so is Caesar and Bluebeard and Horatio Nilsson and...
She's a little trimmer, isn't she?
First, there's something I think I ought to tell you.
Tell me later. I want to see what they're going to do with this oriental cashew.
Madam, won't you sit down? There. Now, just make yourself at home.
Guards, grab her!
Don't you dare touch me! I'm Elsie Smith, I tell you! You can't do this to me! Help! Help!
Look, Herc, why didn't Elsie tell me she was having this party instead of going through that whole business down at the brig?
She wanted to be surprised for you, Purse. That's why I couldn't tell you either.
Certainly is a nice party. What a pity Jellybean can't be here to enjoy it.
Yes, it is bad luck.
Never mind, Herc. I'll make it up to her.
You will? What will you do?
I'll tell her all about it when they let her out of the observation ward tomorrow.
Until next week, when we'll all be back, remember the ABC of good chocolate buying. Always buy Cadbury's. Cadbury's Dairy Milk Chocolate is today's top chocolate value, made from the purest of pure chocolate and the freshest of fresh milk. That's what makes dairy milk so nourishing and what makes each deep bite so satisfying. Dairy milk is just the thing to keep you going whenever you need solid nourishment. Buy a block first thing tomorrow. Only Cadbury's Dairy Milk Chocolate contains a glass and a half of pure, fresh, full cream milk in each half pound. So make dairy milk your daily reason for I Want Cadbury's. In tonight's Cadbury Show, you heard Minnie Love as Minnie, Kevin Brennan as a Purse, Frank Strain as Mr. Hercules, Walter Sullivan as Carew, Ward Leopold as Sam, and as Elsie, Rita Pornsmith. Songs were by Gloria Dawn and James Harris to the music of Iris Mason. The script was by Hugh Stuckey. Now, this is Reginald Goldsworthy saying goodnight from the Cadbury Show.